guys, today I have my Project Pen Pour update for you. This one is really good, really exciting. Let me tell you what I'm trying to do here, just in case if this is the first video you watch from me or from this series. Basically, what I'm trying to do this year is to pan two palettes at the same time, and every month my goal is to just hit pan on one or hopefully a few shades in each palette. Once I hit pan on one palette, I will roll it out and roll in something else to try to hit pan on them. So my goal is basically to hit pan on palettes and not to finish them. And so the two palettes are always, one is one of the oldest palettes in my collection and the other one is always one of the newest palettes in my collection. So that way, you know, I don't neglect either one. So basically, last month I was working on two palettes and I made really good progress on both of them. The newer palette I was using is from Marc Jacobs. This one is the number 7 Style Icon palette, and the shade of the specific palette is called 216 The Enigma. I started using this palette about 2 months ago when I first put it in the project. Before that, I might have used it a week at most. It's just I have two main palettes, they get to sit there and they don't get used. So basically this one is more or so like a spring color palette in my eyes, at least. So I decided to wear it before the weather cools down too much. So when I started using it, it was basically new, and last month I was able to make some dents in some shades, but of course no pan yet. And this time around I was able to hit pan on two shades. Yes, that is a pan. It's hard to see because I hit pan on it and put it away for a couple of weeks now, so I kind of forgot about it already. I'm trying to not blind you here. Here you can see I have pan in this light pink shade right here. It's a small pan, but at the same time the dent is really big, so I believe if I use it more, the pan is gonna expand it pretty fast. Can you tell? That dent is really wide in there. So I'm happy with that pan. I kind of stopped using it once I got pan in that shade. The other pan is much harder to see. It's actually this deep taupe color because the pan is kind of tinted by the color. Here, let me wipe it a slight bit. Maybe you can see it better that way. Okay, there you can see I wiped it a little bit just so that you can see that little speck of pan right in there. It's not super obvious, but it took me a couple of days to realize that's actually pan, just because it's just really hard to see, I realized. This color, I used it a ton mainly on my, just outer corner. I think it's a really elegant shade, and I think it definitely deepens the look, but it doesn't look overly saturated or sexy, so I really like that look. And I would say in this palette I use the top three shades the most, definitely transition color, lid shade, and outer corner, and I can just finish my look with those three. And occasionally I would use the other three shades, but not too much. You can see some little dents in mainly those two, but I only use them every once in a while. I wouldn't think I would be able to hit pan on them even if I use this palette for two more months. It's just not the shades I would use on a daily basis, and the progress isn't going to be all that great. But overall, I think I like this palette, not as much as the Dreamer, which is the one I panned before this one. I think the Dreamer overall, the color is just more warm tone neutrals, and I can use mostly all of the shades. And right here, I have so many colorful ones, I just don't use them on the daily basis. I think it's still a very good quality palette, it's just the shades are not super suitable for my life, I feel. I will keep it around, I would try to use it every once in a while maybe, but for now I'm gonna put it away. The other palette I decided to pan last month was a Z palette, actually, or a self-made palette, basically. I got a whole bunch of shades from The Balm, and I have two palettes from them. One is the Nude Tude, one is the Bon Jovi. I basically depotted both of the palettes and kept a handful of shades from both palettes, not all of them, and I put them all together because the pans are all the same shape. So I actually made a little palette like this myself out of two palettes, and I wanted to pan this combination of shades. So as of last update, which is when I put the palette in this project, I had 9 shades in it. One of them already had pan, that's because I panned it in a different project. I wasn't counting that shade, I was trying to hit pan on one of the rest of the 8 shades there. And this time around, I actually made significant difference here. You can see I have pan in quite a few shades now. Why is it so bright? Right there. Can you tell I actually have pan in 4 shades? And one is from last time. Let me bring it back here. I feel it's just really catching on the light like crazy. So this guy, I already had that pan as of last update, so I wasn't counting that at all. And I was able to hit pan on 3 more shades, this yellow one, this pink one, and this brown one. I definitely like this configuration of colors. I think they are all very workable, very neutral-like, and I can use them every day to work. And I used most of the shades in here, actually, even though some of them obviously didn't have pan yet. But I think it's just such a good combination, and the color are, you know, they're saturated, they are pigmented, I love them, but they are definitely old now. I think that's why I hit pan on them so fast, because they're just getting crumbly, and a lot of powder would kick up whenever I use them. So I think I really love it, and I'm glad I hit pan on a lot of the things. But if I used the same palette, say 3 years ago, I wouldn't have hit pan on them so fast, if that makes sense. I think they're just turning old now. And also at the same time, because how much I enjoyed this little palette and how fast I was able to go through them, I was even thinking I want to pan this completely next year. I don't think it would take me long at all if I just use this solely. I think I can even finish this little configuration in 4 or 5 months. That's my estimate. Of course, you're gonna get like 1 or 2 shades that surprise you, right? But I think I'm really tempted to pan it next year. I just really, really enjoy all the shades here and all the looks I get out of them, and also because how fast they went, you know, why not? So yeah, I think I probably would pan this next year. Okay, so that means I got 2 palettes out of the way. I have to roll in 2 more palettes, and the one to replace my newer palette here, it's gonna be my Anastasia the Prism palette. So I talked about this in a haul about 2-3 months ago. I got it from TJ Maxx, and one of the shades was cracked in it. I wanted to return it. I asked you guys about it, all that, but I think in the end I just really wanted it, so I didn't return it. I kept it. I repressed that one cracked shade, and I'm actually using it now, and it's a little dirty and dusty, but I'm gonna show you what it looks like. So here it is. You can see that I mainly focused on 2 shades right here, and that is the cracked one. I repressed it, and you can see that's why it has a dent, because I lost a lot of the product in the process as well. But basically, this is where it is at right now. I haven't used all of the shades, honestly. I, you know, try to use 2-3 shades as a combination every once in a while, so I don't know. I would be able to pan a lot of the shades, basically like a deep purple or deep green. I probably wouldn't touch them too much, but I think I can hit pan on a couple of other shades, especially a lot of you guys who have panned Anastasia shadows say that they are really easy to hit pan on and really easy to pan. So I have high hopes that I can, you know, get pan on a couple or even more shades in this palette. And I think this palette looks really gorgeous. I really like the shades in here. And also you can see that they're pretty dusty. Just the kick up from this powder, can you tell? Like, it got into those shades. So I think for that reason, it's gonna go fast. Powdery shades tend to go fast anyways. So I have high hopes. I think I can probably hit pan on 1 or 2 shades in this palette in the next month or so, and I really enjoy the shades in here, so why not? I'm gonna work on that one. And to replace my old palette, I honestly, this is like a last minute decision, because in this palette I feel the only thing that's lacking for me is a lighter transition shade. So for me, I think this shade right here, what is it, Unity is more like a overall setting powder for me, just because of my skin tone. And I feel right here, Eden, is just slightly a little bit too pink and too dark for my liking as a transition color. And all the other shades are pretty shimmery, and this one is also a little bit too dark as a transition color for me. I want something else that I can use to help with the situation, basically. So I went with my Lorac Pro. Gosh, I've had this palette for so many years now, and I rarely used it. I bought it and maybe used it for like a month or so and put it away, and mine is very new. Like, I obviously finished one shade that was in one of my projects, and I finished that one. Everything else is barely touched, and I just, you know, some of you guys have already panned this palette completely. I figured for me, I don't need to pan it. I just want to work on it a little bit more. I probably would try to focus more just on those lighter matte shades right here, just because of the situation. I want the Prism palette to be my main focus, and then this one would be a little bit more or so like a companion palette in that. So that's basically my reasoning, and you can see that they are all barely touched, so new. It's crazy, but yeah, I want to work on those two palettes. They're both pretty big palettes. Let's be honest, there are a lot of shades in here. If I want variety, I definitely get the variety. If I want to go neutral, I have neutral options or colorful options, you know, if I want to go colorful. So I think I'm pretty well covered for the next month or so, maybe even 2 months. I don't think I can hit pan on both of them next month. There's no way. But yeah, I think I'm happy with my choices. I would really like to see some pan in those bigger palettes. So hopefully I can make some good progress next month. And of course, if you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to give me a like and also subscribe to my channel. And thank you guys for watching. Bye.